Thank you, Jesus, for giving us a heads up on what's going on and how to handle it. My dear family, I want to share with you the reading the Lord gave me from Scripture yesterday. I do believe it will help you. In 2 Samuel, beginning around chapter 15, there's a story of King David's son, Absalom, and he was beginning a rebellion against his father. He deceived the people and turned their hearts to himself and against his father. Then he led a rebellion by popular opinion because he had courted the people to win their hearts behind his father's back. And so David again had to run for his life. But by divine providence, during the battle between David and Absalom's troops, Absalom's hair got caught in the low-hanging branches of a tree, which his mule ran under, and he could not free himself. And there he met his fate as he was killed by David's men. In summary, it looked very bad for David, who was a great warrior, who seemed to have lost the popular vote. He had to abandon the palace and go into hiding, so many were in Absalom's army. However, God stepped in and brought an end to him, and David's kingdom was united, and he returned to his palace and built it up. No other nation was able to bring David down, and so in peace his kingdom went on to his son Solomon. Dear family, even when it looks bad, God is the turnaround specialist, and he will have his way with America. But I am asking you to devote this day to prayer and fasting, and in fact, continue to pray and fast until this battle is won. I know many of you must work and take care of your children, so I'm asking you to deny yourself the foods you love and get by on lesser foods until this is resolved. You could give up sodas and desserts and savory foods. And if this continues to go on as an issue, let down on your fasting on Saturdays for a day of rest and on Sundays, the Lord's Day, and then pick it up again during the week. But I would like you to consider for a moment before you do go into prayer. Really think about this, guys. What are the consequences of this battle? If we lost, if we are not vigilant to pray and fast, this nation could be destroyed overnight. Defunding of the military and the police, persecution like never before of Christians, censorship and lies meant to turn the world against us, and the end of freedom in this nation. Just imagine what it would be like without police to call, as people were trying to break into your house. Imagine what it would be like to see foreign armies, especially the Chinese, rolling into towns and taking people from their homes to be locked into camps. Imagine the serious consequences for your families and children. And after you've thought about all these things, guys, go into prayer with conviction and passion. Let the evildoers and the cheats be exposed for what they are, and let the legitimate election continue for the American people to elect their president. And I asked the Lord if he had anything to add, and Jesus began, "Your prayers are working. Keep praying. This is my word to you. Defend your rights, yes, but do it in the context of prayer and fasting. Your prayers are working. Keep praying. Those of you who have slacked off in prayer, repent and get back on your knees until this situation is decided. There is nothing more powerful than prayer. Nothing. It is by prayer that I defeated armies far greater than the number of men on my side. Remember Gideon's 300 and get to prayer. Make this day count for your nation and the kingdom of God, which I long to bring on this earth. Nothing in your life will matter if you lose this battle. So put your all into this, my people, and I will show you a great victory. Do not let me down. Press into prayer. There is nothing in your life right now more important than prayer. I am at your right hand, praying with you, and together we will obtain the victory. Amen.